Hey everyone, Gab Nassif, and today I'm going to be playing Modern. I'm going to be playing the coolest deck I could find from this weekend's top 8 challenges. I've been playing mostly the same decks lately. I've been playing more banned RKDs in Modern, been going decently. I've been playing more Esper Legends in Standard, more Blue-Black Control in Pioneer. So nothing too new on my side. Figured I'd go find see if anyone else was up to anything cool. And I found a Cicerus MTG, came in second in the Swiss, lost in the quarters, I think, but cool take on Agoria's Vengeance deck was Atraxa. And excited to see what this deck's about. I've played some Asmo decks before, but I don't think I've ever played Agoria's Vengeance list. I've played Persist with Archon of Cruelty. This is a little different though. This is a little more all in, I guess. So yeah, excited to see what this deck's about. I'm gonna go through the list real quick. So you're trying to either, you know, win with Asmo plus the cookbook, or at least buy yourself some time. You've got Devil to get a lot of free foods into play. You've got Blood Token that enables the discard out aspect of your deck. I guess the other part of the deck is trying to bring back Emrakul or Atraxa was Gora's Vengeance. And to enable that, you've got the discard of the blood tokens, of cookbook, of brutality, as well as Profane Tutor to find the missing pieces and Thoughtseize to protect your combo. We see one Bone Shards. I like that card a lot. I think it's a strong card. It can enable the discard part. It's also nice, I guess, to be able to find a few spells with Atraxa. Looking at the list, I'm guessing once you cast Atraxa, you can maybe assemble another Atraxa, Reanimate, or Emrakul, or maybe find just enough interaction between Asmo and Cookbook to definitely take over the game. There's also Urza's Saga, which is only getting the Cookbook in game one, so super focused main deck, no weird one-ofs, no targets for Saga. And no way to cast, to hard cast the Atraxa, just some black and green mana. I don't think there's any treasure tokens or anything. So it'd be pretty hard to get to 7 mana. Anyways, I guess a nice bonus is you're probably pretty good against Mill game one. Who knows, maybe deck's not that good and Sisters just got paired against Mill 4 times in a row. We'll see. But yeah, like this deck, Profane Tutor is super good card. If it wasn't for Teferi's passive, I feel like that card would see way more play and we'd see way more black-based deck, maybe like the Coffers deck, because it is totally brutal when you suspend this card and they just drop Teferi. You also see this deck has no ways to get rid of a Teferi, really. You have Thoughtseize to discard it, but that's it. So I don't think Asmo targets Planeswalker, right? Target creature deals 6 damage to itself, yeah. So yeah, that's the deck. Sideboard for ley lines. Anti-discard, I guess, helps you against burn. Fruit of Breach for people hating on the graveyard. You know, they go low, you go high, I guess. Cool part, you get the companion, always nice. I guess that's a way to cast Atraxa. Maybe that happens. I take it all back. You can easily cast Atraxa. I'm guessing it happens a decent bit. Do you have enough interaction? Yeah, you Asmo, you Thoughtseize, you grind a bit, dropping a... We'll see. That could be like a nice little bet on this league. Am I going to hard cast tracks? That was Giganta. And then we got some good targets for our Urza Saga, second to Seju, and a couple Fatal Push. Could see some Fatal Push in the main deck, but I guess the main deck's really all about the combo. So, yeah, that's the deck. Gonna jump into a league. Before I do, I'd like to shout out CFB Pro. If you're looking for more strategic content, more videos, definitely check out CFB Pro. Deck guides, strategy articles written by some of the best players in the world. Right now, you've got, if you want to see more Atraxa content, you've got Jesse Robkin, who wrote an article about Atraxa and Pioneer. There's a cool Neoform deck that's trying to put Atraxa and Plane to Pioneer. So they wrote about that. Check out CFB Pro. Only $7 a month, and you get TCG Player Premium with that. They work together, so You can get free shipping, free tracking from TCG players. A ton of good stuff. But yeah, get in a league. See yeah, we do. Is that a pairing right away? No. I've been a bit all around the place lately. I'm trying to play a bit of Standard because the next Pro Tour is Standard. It's in coming up soon. It's in 5 weeks now. There will be a new set, but I'm trying to keep up to date on Standard. I still really like Esper Legends, even though the Grixis builds are all tougher to beat now. I've been playing a bit of Pioneer, played Blue-Black Control a bit. Been a bit underwhelmed. Rakdos is still really tough, so yeah, not sure how I feel about it. What else? Modern, I've been playing the Bant Arcades deck. Been tuning the deck. I can show you real quick while we wait. Where are you? Is it Morbin time still? I did try Ella Demerskull as a two-off, and I decided I just wanted Teferi and Arcades instead. More of the same stuff. Cull was not terrible, but it was not good enough. And yeah, right now, I guess my one flex slot is the Second Witness. Could be Teferi number four, Second Witness, another Hierarch. I wish this deck just had a good one drop. As far as like Thraven Inspector are not quite good enough. And then sideboard, yeah. You could play Verge Tender on the main, but that's all extreme. Been trying some cards. I played a challenge with Emrakul and Ulamog in my sideboard for the mill matchup, but didn't get paired against mill. Been trying a bunch of stuff, but this is kind of more or less what I like right now. All right. Let's see. Let's make the window smaller, maybe like this. Reveal Giganta. Okay. Surely this hand does something, right? Just Thoughtseize into Saga Bertelli. I mean, looks kind of perfectly fine. Little added bonus, I guess, is people, if they don't know what you're up to, they're probably going to put you on Green Tron. Speaking of... That's so funny, actually. Oh, beautiful. Crab is too toughness, right? I mean, they're in for a rough time. What do I even take? None of these cards really do anything. I guess Fracture Sanity Cycles? But they don't get to play Crab next turn, dude. Poor opponents. I mean, I don't even think they play Surgical in the main deck anymore. Not too sure. Guess we'll see. Do I go for the drain? No. -2/-2. Reveal your hand. Opponent, Crab. Discard the Daredevil. Oh, that's true. They also mail my devils. I mean, I don't even know. It's just the visions. Kind of annoying. They do get my let's see, if I play Saga, they're probably gonna want a Field of Ruin my other Saga, so I get to use that one next turn. I'm not in a super rush. Let's just fetch. I think you just get dual lens here. I don't need red or green, right? I guess I need it for Giganta. Vesaju, so I'll get Overgrown Tomb. Let's start making tokens. There's the Emrakul trigger. Checking for Daredevil. I do have a Daredevil, so I'm going to make a token with the trigger on the stack. Pretty cool. Unlucky. I don't know if that means they don't have Surgical or any ways to exile the graveyard in the main deck. I don't know if I know their last card. I don't think I do. I mean, I could check, I guess, but let's see. Start with Urza Saga. Doria's Vengeance Atraxa. All right, they've seen enough. I mean, Leyline's probably really good. Some of their stuff don't target, though, and the cards I'm worried about are... Soulgad Lantern? Let's see. I don't think Soulgad Lantern targets. Each opens graveyards. And Tasha's Hideous Laughter doesn't target either. Each opponent, yeah. So Leyline's actually not that good. Needle. The cards are not that bad. My main deck's not that bad. They're going to have a lot of graveyard hate. Problem is Fruit of Breach. They only have one Blood Crypt and they have four Field of Ruin, so that part's kind of tough. Surgical. Trying to think what could be good. Leyline doesn't stop the cards I care about. Fruit of Breach, probably okay. No, but it's got the Blood Crypt problem. Let's just keep it. Don't Fatal Push over anything. Let's keep it that way. I think I want just my main deck's fine. It's honestly going to be much tougher after sideboards. Could have maybe brought in Might to get rid of Lantern. Seems fine for Maul. I should bring in Pithing Needle. That's the card I should have brought in. Duh. Is a turn on Saga deck? I don't think so. Game one's a freebie, but that might just be an underdog after sideboard. We shall see. Drawing all my basics, not great. I mean, drawing land, bad. Drawing basic, even worse. How long does that stay? Return target legendary creature from graveyard to the battlefield. That creature can stay exiled at the beginning of the next end step. The beginning of the next end step. Also, it'd be nice to get the Emrakul nice and early so then they don't get too much of my deck. I see the more they get with Lantern, the worse it is for me. Oh, wow. Okay. After win was Urza Saga and Asmo. Come play. There's not good reanimate spells. Persist is non-legendary creatures. So you gotta pick Archon and Persist or... Damn. Villains in a row. Not even a second saga. Not great. I guess I have the Gigantai angle. Looking forward to that. And still no Emrakul. This is, then they got 8 cards with Thingy, including an Emrakul. They got 7 cards, then the Emrakul. I guess it's mana value 20 or more. All right, they're down to 2 cards. They have that crab, though. Give them value. Might just not be able to... This first. Get bone shards. Let's see. I should have had needle. I've just got a needle here. What a huge mistake. I mentioned Soul Got Lanterns like 20 times and then didn't get needle. Kind of just want to make tokens. Well, I guess I'm going to get cookbooks. I'm going to get to cast Asmo anyways. Brutality's kind of okay. The Daredevil's kind of okay, I guess. Is it just Daredevil? I don't hate it. Tutor Bug. Right, it does that as well. I think I should have fast enough clock. It's gonna be close. We have 2 Emrakuls left. I guess it's not going to be that close. I have like 2 turn clock. Might even have to chump this turn. Yeah, this matchup is... As if that had a field of ruin this game, it would have been way different. Oh, it's a draw. Let's play this. Not do I even care? Damn, so cool. They stopped my combo, but doesn't matter. I guess it could have me technically. Not sure what they would need though. They need to mill 24 cards. Was that Hide Emrakul the first time? Second lantern. I guess it's all too hard for them. There's too many things. Because they kept seven cards too. Felt like they were short on resources. All right. Kind of a freebie. I haven't played against, let's see, how much Modern have I played lately? I've played Atrons in a challenge. In like my last 20 matches, I haven't had played against Mel. Until you play maybe against Mel once every about that 20, 25 matches. Still pretty popular. Hence the Emrakul in my sideboard. The new Jay's pretty good for them. But I saw this was only two. It was really good against my Arcades deck because I'm pretty bad at attacking Planeswalkers. But yeah, I guess if mill is predominant in your local meta for some reason. It's a good deck. Yes, while we wait for round two, I'll shout out Ultimate Guard to our amazing sponsor. They make some of the greatest deck boxes, sleeves in the business, arguably the best. Cool designs, great quality, different materials. They even have deck boxes made out of renewable material. They have katana sleeves, top-notch quality sleeves, just anything you need to protect your cards and your deck. Shape, size, forms. You got it. Seems like a fine hand, right? Double cookbook. Like I can turn to Asmo and kill a creature, and I have a saga, and if I draw Garu's Vengeance, I might just win on the spot. Playing against creativity. Ooh, I drew Daredevil too. Is there a reason why I would want a saga on turn one? I don't think so. Is Asmo not the greatest against creativity? Too bad it doesn't shoot planeswalkers. All right. 4 out, 8%, something like that. Can I do always yes? Or is it because it's going to be a different one every time it's going to forget? All right, I guess I am not playing Asmo. Probably just died to a lightning bolt anyways. So you don't have too much to stop me unless you have Teferi. I guess that's not true. There's Leyline Binding, applying protection from spells that are... Oh, wow. If they're playing the Binding version, they have Teferi to stop Tutor and Binding to just... Right, because Jace can bounce Emrakul, right? Flying protection from spells that are one or more colors. I actually don't know what that means. I almost discarded Emrakul there. Is the trigger of binding a spell or is it a trigger? I want to say it's probably just a trigger, but could be wrong. Just happy to make a token here, I think. Do I just win if they tap out for, I don't know, I'm going for creature. And they do have Teferi. Yeah. Tough. Let's see, I should do this first. So I don't just lose my token to Lightning Bolt. Oh, I guess it would have been 4-4 anyways. I jinx myself talking about Teferi. I guess I should just go face, right? Or is instant speed creativity a pain? They can probably only creativity for one. I can just sack Asmo. Do I just have lethal somehow? Even putting them at one would be good. Not quite lethal. Got them in bolt range. Yeah, I mean, I can kill the Archon too, was the trigger on the stack. They need a bunch of removal for... well. Yeah, creativity was not enough. All right, let's see. I don't know if they get graveyard hate. I don't really want push. Needle is okay, but it doesn't solve my Teferi problem. Leyline stops the... Let's see. I don't think they're playing discard spells. Leyline stops the Archon trigger. Do I have bad cards in my main deck? Profane Tutor... is really bad. Everything else is pretty good. They're gonna avail, let's see. Might. Spell bomb. Seju could be kind of okay. I think Tutor into Teferi is just too brutal. Windcharge skills a Planeswalker. Ley lines. Trying to think. Probably have binding. Dice to Rend. I need to like hold. I'll bring in one. Bring in the one spell bomb, needle, another Buseju, and I guess that's it. Don't Fruita Breach in this matchup. They're gonna keep in all their spell pierce, I think. I don't feel like Fruita Breach is especially good against them. But maybe it's better than the one ofs. I'll just do this, the Fruita Breach. And what else did I bring in? Because I cut four of these. I brought in Buseju, sure. I guess Leyline's really bad against Teferi. And they can get rid of it, most likely. Okay. They're mulling to six. Hopefully they don't have to turn on fetch lands. Need to respect Veil of Summer here. Can I respect Veil of Summer with my hand though? I don't think so. The upside of them veiling is that they have to fetch for Stomping Ground, which hopefully mana screws them at least. Might make their mana awkward. Bolt? Oh. Okay, that's better than Veil. Did not see that one coming. Let's see. So next turn, I can Thoughtseize myself and Warrior's Vengeance. Dawn of Brutality just on the off chase that you're a spell. Brutality's not getting much better. Maybe next turn. Maybe I can play a little slow. Hopefully they just step out for Teferi and I get to Emrakul them. That'd be the dream scenario. Step out for anything really, Fable. Wait, Teferi stops my combo. I'm so dumb. Oof. Well. I would love Teferi. All right, that's how my deck works, right? Double checking. Target player, choose a non-land. Guard's Vengeance instant speed. So far, so good. Sounds like that might be a decent matchup, though. Feels like your deck kind of trumps theirs. Gavanachi. Played against Gavanachi not long ago. Seems great. Wow. Sizzik just busted, or am I getting like top percentiles of hand and getting paired against mill and stuff? I have to play that deck some more. Could have taken Ren and then brutality them next turn, and then they're gonna spell pierce it. But Ren's not very scary. I think for smart commands, probably better for them right now. I don't know. It's probably close. I don't think I need red mana in my main deck. Archon. All right, we're about to find out, or at least start answering the question, is Atraxa, bringing back an Atraxa, enough to keep you going? It's kind of hard to keep track of the lands. Archon's their relevant card. All right, let's see. Definitely want another Glorious Vengeance. Also, I don't have the choice. Same for Cookbook. Oh, I get Enchantment. And land. And the only decision is Daredevil or Asmo. It's Asmo. Okay, hopefully. I think I got everything I could get, right? So thought seizing them now, I don't think does a ton for me. They're at 7, they have a billion lands. So I guess I should just attack them. And then next turn, I can do it again. So they need... What do they need? I'm not sure they can really have anything. Teferi doesn't stop my combo this time. They know about Gore's Vengeance, but they don't know about Atraxa number 2. So they could still be hoping I don't have it. Not sure they can beat Thoughtseize plus Vengeance on Atraxa. This is a spot where you want to be like, I have it. Ah, this deck's been pretty convincing so far. What's the other mode? Discard two, draw two. I think I had F6 at first. I don't know. What the? All right, so what did I do? I just did Fruit of Reach. I think most lists play Teferi. We saw Jetnir's Garden. Like they don't have to play white if they're not playing Teferi and Binding. I don't think so. I think one might is probably okay. Could do one might over one Basejo. It might just be the mites are better than Fruit of Reach in this matchup. Kills a Fable, kills a Binding. Dice to Ren, so it's kind of hard to run it out there and keep it. Sage's got the surprise effect. Yeah, maybe the Sage is just better. If it wasn't for the Tutor of Saga. I'll try. You bring in Leyline, you lose Giganta too. Obviously, if you know for a fact they don't have Teferi, almost definitely keep in all the tutors. Maybe bring in one Fruit of Breach. You can tutor four. Alright, opponent's time turn to be deep in the tank for the sideboard. Probably haven't played that matchup much. Maybe not at all. I'm drawing too well for Giganta to be good so far. Sand doesn't do much. It casts Asmo, but I don't have thingy. I need to draw a Garry's Vengeance or Daredevil. There's a lot of cards I can draw, but I also feel like there's a lot of better hands I can have. I guess I'll keep. It's bad, though. It's real bad. Turn five. Against someone who's playing Spell Tears. Urza Saga is really good. I'm gonna mulligan again. Just like this. Get rid of both Fruit of Reach. I think doesn't really need a third land though. Alright. Guess I was due for. It's probably due for a non-functioning land. Spell Pierce. Mm-hmm. All right, I need an Urza Saga. Not sure what else I can draw. I mean, obviously, combination of cards, but... maybe I'll get my beatdown on this game. Let me guess, you thought I was dead. I think I just let them have it. I don't think Besaju Fable is a winning line here. We'll see. Actually, if I draw land, I might do it. Oh, that's actually discard for Asmo. Cool. Doesn't do anything for me, but this cool. Yeah, I'm just going to play Besaju, I guess. All right. Oh, forgot about Giganta. Punt. I guess it's good to see a little fail rate too. All right, I have that card. Oh, that's a good one to discard. So maybe I want my own spell bombs. I got wrecked by that card before. What was I playing? I don't remember, but it totally wrecked me. It's good too. It's enough to fight off Living End as well, and it's good against discards. I don't even think it targets, right? Choose up to three cards in graveyards. Yeah. Really nice. Didn't draw to discard too. Creativity for two. Edge. I mean, I guess Emrakul at 15. That'd be so funny. You didn't have spell pierce and I drew a land. Damn, if I'd kept land over Daredevil, maybe that was the plan. They're not even drawing. Might not think Spell Pierce is good anymore, though. In a hard cast Archon. Which I guess doesn't kill me. Gives them a flying blocker. Does it have protection from some flying protection? No. Yeah, so they put an Archon into play. It's pretty much GG. Oh yeah, I forgot Giganta again. Impressive. Teferi plus is annoying. Oh, you're casting a Yuno? Funny because they're probably gonna name black, but and the flying blocker is enough. I guess they should name black since they don't care about red. Oh no, it's right. Protection from creatures. Wow. I should draw bone shards. See, that it's not Glorious Vengeance. I might have won. I'm not technically dead on board. So I guess I'll play it out. Keep forgetting my cards have text. Surely they don't have a removal spell slash burn spell slash creativity slash archon slash literally every spell in there that kills me. Yeah, good enough. Twenty-two lands, Fruit of Breach, 5 mana. Man, turn the earth's really good against me. Jeez. What a beating. All right, I have good answers to anything they do. A second Baseju over Fruit of Breach. Kind of makes sense. 5 mana is a lot. Gives me an extra land. Like, decent against them. It's an extra source of green, I guess, for mites. Alright, Giganta. We'll remember you. Yeah, Snapkeep. Wow. Not exactly what you want, I think. Especially against stupid Turn the Earth. Veil of Summer. Emissary, creativity, binding. Just take the creativity, right? It's easy. Rest of their hand basically doesn't do anything. It's my draw. And there's Spell Pierce. That's really good for me. It's actually really good for me. Couldn't care less about that cookbook. I don't know. I think it's bugged. You have to pay. Yep. Oh, I don't know why I did that. I think it's bugged. You have to say no twice for some reason. All right, Giganta will have to wait a bit. Okay, not the best draw, but don't really need to draw anything. Just need them not to draw anything. Mm-hmm. Unless they run the perfect on me, I should be good. So, do I get the mites? Now? Or do I get a cookbook? I'm gonna go Saga. I have at least one card I can discard. Might on Binding doesn't do anything. The creativity next turn. I'm not gonna have untapped green anyways. I guess I could play Bloodstainmire, but it's not good. Need to play that second Saga. Does the cookbook. This is enchantment too for each artifact. I wonder if I discard Blooming March or not. They're probably going to bind a construct anyways, right? I could. I have lands for the next two turns. Could play that land tap next turn though, get it out of the way. Huh. I guess the fairy would be pretty good for them here. They get to fairy bounce their binding. Buy them some old time. That goes through their deck. As it can just bounce the token, I'm dumb. Yeah. That's some good draws for them. This could have just been creativity. All right, just play my land and say go. You just discard Daredevil while... I guess when they fetch, while they're tapped out. They might just be flooded. They might just be flooded and have drawn that return the earth card. Oh, I'll probably lose if they draw creativity. They have that veil still in hand. These have bone shards if ever their plans to tap out for emissary. Okay, they didn't attack. So at least that means they probably don't have creativity yet. Wouldn't have made any help, but I just let Urza Saga die in that spot, just forget to respond to the trigger for some reason. Alright, still want might. Doesn't do much. Cookbook. Yeah, just faster clock. Maybe attack the fairy. Let's see, I tagged them. Let's say they have nothing relevant. I tagged them, they chomp, maybe they take it once. Go down to like sixth. And then have double lethal. Ticks up, you can double chomp block. What's forcing a chomp more? Me attacking Teferi? don't think they have another Teferi, but they could draw another Teferi. They draw creativity, I'd probably lose anyways. I guess it's just because it's awkward if I send to Fairy. Yeah, I'm not sure. Sure what not chomping means for me. And I've turned the earth. Can't put an artifact into play at instant speed, can I? Wait, I can literally have another cookbook in hand in play. You know they have Veil, so I'm just going to discard Bone Shards. They just messed that up. Could have waited for the second one. Do they have? They drew both. That'd be funny. Can't hear it, but it's pretty sweet djembe action, drums going up, going on. Yagi Bombs, maybe some of you know him. He used to stream a bit. He was asking me if I want to play Explorer next week. There's the qualifier on Arena. It's gonna be Explorer. All right, well, we know their hands, so they're just literally dead on board if they break. Okay, that keeps them alive a turn. But now they're kind of now they're kind of hellbent. I think they're drawing dead. Seju. Oh no, I'm dumb. They're not drawing dead at all. Classic. Let you have Teferi. Artifact enchantment non basic. Yeah. Trying to see if any of my cards do anything here. All right, so oh my god, oh no, never mind, they were not dead. I was gonna say I could have gotten Giganta discarded to the cookbook. Wait, what? It gains life. Oh, it's so good. But never mind, they have Gores not do anything. All right. Ooh. I was thinking, oh, get Giganta, discard it, get it back for Gorius, but yeah, no, my plan's not gonna work very well. Awkward. Well, lost in the sauce this game. Match league. Learning together. Go up to 10, but I don't mind discarding my hand. I still have to double chum block. Oh, they probably shouldn't have done it right away. I don't think the Seju does much, so might as well put that in my hand. Say go. If I can, I can't kill my own stuff. Can I sack it? No, I cannot. Just making sure I don't miss anything. Oh, they're at 10. They're at 10. Villain Emissary don't do much. I just want to cast a Giganta, maybe. Surprised if I want to have lethal, I need to discard one card, but all of my cards could be good. Giganta could be good. Cards Vengeance could be good. And fifth land's obviously kind of good. Putting them down to one is good enough. I'm playing Asmo this turn, so I'm not playing Giganta. I want to keep Baseju. Let's discard. Did you get to cycle their Veil, though? I play Asmo for lethal. It's just like attack. Because if they get to cycle their Veil and they have a removal for the construct, kind of a disaster for me. I feel like I'm just chilling right now. We'd get another cookbook, which doesn't do a ton for me. Yeah, I'm not sure what to do here. I don't want to just cast Giganta. Do that. Could put them down to one anyways. I don't even know how much they have that. Oh, there's also that. Could just besiege the binding? But then I give them a second white mana? You and creatures you control have protection. They name creature, and this doesn't work anymore, right? Sacrifice 2 feats, target creature shield, deal 6 damage to itself. So Ceremasteria has protection from itself. This is kind of scary. And I can put them down to 1. It does go for it. The Comcast Emissary was at fetching. Could get Baseju. Discard Giganta. Discard Maid Gorya's Vengeance. Or to stay at 10, I cast Giganta and then have a slow, freaking super slow clock. All right, this is so tough. All right, I'm going to Baseju the Binding. I guess they need fetch for Foundry to fetch for untap white. They might not even have a third untap white. Let's see what they get. I guess they have another Triumph. Right, just get a dwarf in mind. Oh my god. I think it's probably still worth it, actually. Yeah, it's probably still fine. Well, now I probably just want to play my Asmo, so let's discard Giganta. And do I want to put them down to 1? Does bringing back Giganta do anything? No. What? Discarding Asmo? Getting it back. That doesn't do anything either. I wonder if I keep my Gorya's Vengeance or not. I think 2 is good enough, putting them at 2. Alright, hopefully this is not a mistake, but I can't imagine it is at this point. Should I kill the token now? Sure. This way, if they draw removal of the veil, like if they draw lightning bolt of the veil, I can, they can't just kill my Asmo. Yeah. If they draw bolt and I don't kill the token, they kill Asmo and then they get to keep their token. I'm not even sure what they can draw at this point. Even like putting an Archon into play doesn't save them anymore. Oh, I could have killed it. I guess I can Gorya's Vengeance Giganta. I guess, yeah, I should have sacked. I should have made it kill itself. That was a mistake. Uh-oh. You know, I'm not they can really draw that much. Spell Pierce doesn't do it. All right, that was much closer. Just a little bit closer. Ugh. wasn't super comfortable there. I don't know if I made mistakes. Probably. There's a lot of, like, small interesting decisions. Maybe they weren't that tough in hindsight. I'm glad I didn't go all in on that one token. That would have been a disaster. I guess that was where I dodged a bullet. If I'd just gone all in, discarded my entire hand to have a 10-10, I'd have gotten right by the binding. Or not. Could have kept Buseju maybe as my one card. Discard everything but Buseju, and I'd binding doesn't even work. It would have to be like Prismari Command. I'm not too sure. Seju was good for me. Ooh, winning the Dire. Ooh, Respect the Cats. Giga Grinder. Respect the Cats thing is like... Spam Zomnaf, I want to say. What's better here? Blood Fountain or the Cookbook? There's nothing I really want to discard, right? Blood Fountain's probably better. Rather discard to that than to... Just get rid of a cookbook, right? Minor misstep. It'd be so funny. Temple Garden. Temple Garden, not Triumph. Maybe they don't have a white-green Triumph. Maybe they only play Ketria Triumph and Rogrin Triumph. Maybe they're just not playing what I think they're playing. It's like the Cat Trophy Leader. Up there for sure. Not bad. Yeah. Yeah, just start making token of Saga, see where that gets us. It's kind of nice to be in that spot where if you ever draw Gar's Vengeance, you kind of win on the spot. Wait, this only gives you one blood token? Sometimes I thought it made two blood tokens, because that'd be a lot, two blood, three artifacts for one card. Maybe I should have saved, Yeah. Kind of messed up, I think. For some reason, I thought it gave you two blood token. Well. See, I almost did it again. Wait, are they playing my deck? Nah. That'd be cool. This is probably better than Asmo, right? More artifacts this turn, surprise effect. Yeah, might just be my deck. Might just be Arcades. Strategizing over there. But then knows what's up. Bane Tutor. I I don't have a cookbook left to fetch. Let's see. Could discard Emrakul, shuffle back a cookbook, get back a cookbook. That can be worth it, right? All right, hopefully they're not playing main deck dress down. That'd be brutal. Still looking like my deck. Nothing left to get, Sag. Terrible deck building. I think I should discard land, discard tutor. Well, I should be attacking first, really. It could have ephemerate. Memory tricks me. Okay, I guess I'm gonna send two tokens at them and then Asmo at Teferi. I don't wanna get wrecked by ephemerate. I almost ran into that. That'd have been bad. Wait, what? One white. Ending. Okay, I'd have solitude, right? All right, it's close. Whether I should kill something. The pitch cold, it could have ephemerate, could kill the witness, but then ephemerate wrecks me. Well, I thought that game was super over. I actually lost because I didn't discard Emrakul and got another cookbook. Pipe dream. It's not even good against Teferi. I don't know why I didn't do it. Wow. Eldritch Evolution. Cool. That's that omnath. It's gotta be. Knight of Bottom. Okay. Hmm. It's a good draw. I don't have it. Two evolutions and a call. Let she lose to any spell in their deck, almost, it feels like. Yeah, mistakes were made this game. I need a Daredevil. That'd be sick. Tracks. Okay. At least I could find a Guardian's Vengeance now. They're freaking wrecked. That's the card they drew, really? Must be. Yeah, game's kind of on me, though. I think I messed up. Oh, and I forgot to put Giganta in my hand. Oh my god. I'm the actual worst. Let's put Giganta, and it's actually relevant. Oh, that's... I was game losing. Wow, that sucks. Is their hand's probably awkward? I wonder what their 5-drop is. Oh wow. I was in decent shape, but not done the mistake. I would have killed it. I guess the Atraxa wouldn't be in my yard though. Do I always get Atraxa? Elishnorn. And they drew really well, but I should have won that game. Oh, I guess I win. I think I win. Who needs a trigger? That was lucky. That was a little lucky. Wow. It's like my Arcades deck, but better. I don't know about Call, though. Call seemed Call and Eldritch Evolution. A lot of Dirtling. Not sure I can get behind that. Root of Breach. I don't think my cards really do much. Probably have Ephemerate, so Brutality is probably good. Fatal Push, probably not very good. Tutor is pretty bad again. I guess I'll do Fruit of Breach for the Tutors, and then... do Spellbomb for Witness. Or could do some Fatal Push. I'll do the Spellbomb. That's funny, my mistake kind of won me the game. Because if I've discarded a track sign Giganta. So what do I need for this hand to be good? Like a Guardian's Vengeance, a Saga. Asmo would be okay. I think I'll keep. Because they have Solitude, they have like Interaction. I don't know if... like, I kind of feel like I need my resources a bit in this matchup. It's looking maybe just the game's a little slow. I can cast a Giganta. I'm not sure. I think this is probably a tough matchup, honestly. Night of Autumn, Endurance, Solitude, Teferi. I don't know, maybe my hand's just unkeepable too. Who knows? I wonder if they have the one up Arcades with all their tutors. World of Walls, just drawing it is nice. Evolution. I have Bone Shards. What's the worst that could happen? Okay, they do have Omnath. Beg the Cat is an Omnath gamer. Alright, I guess gotta hope they don't have Endurance in hand. I don't have much of a choice. Not like I can let them untap with Omnath. Okay. Should be good enough. Let's see. All right, well, I'm definitely taking the only land I can take. Only sorcery I can take. Which creature, though? Which creature, which artifact? Does Cookbook over Fountain ever make sense? Not really, so I'll take Fountain. Land, sorcery, artifacts. Which creature do I want? I think Emrakul. I think Fruit of Reach Emrakul is probably best. One's good against... Emrakul's good against... Alec Norn. But bad against Solitude. What about just Asmo? All underwhelming. The Daredevil. Let's take Emrakul, I guess. Why did I discard Collective Brutality? I don't want to discard Fruit of Reach. I don't want to give it away. Also, I might just need both. Brutality probably doesn't do too much. It's land. Exile. I have black mana too. Probably binding. I wonder if I need to worry about Veil of Summer. Let's cast Brutality first. Better to bait with that if they actually have Veil. Or Force of Vigor, Endurance, not around now. And they have the Solitude. Right, just Solitude. Just Solitude, they're gonna have two draw steps to draw another one. And if I do, I still have redraws. Just another Emrakul. I kept on that because it's their only green card. I was wondering why they played Teferi over Elmnath. Like they didn't expect the Fruit of Reach. Well, just like we drew it, Fruit of Reach to be the graveyard hate. Nice. Felt like kind of a tough matchup. I don't know. Need to draw. Yeah. Close. Ooh, first trophy of the season for me. I played very little Modern. Even less leagues. Usually when I play Modern, it's prelim or challenges. Not that I usually do well when I play a lot of Modern leagues anyways. I don't know if these people do it. It's really impressive. Well, video is not going to be as long as last time. The 3.5 hours league was the blue light control. Old change of pace. And I've been playing slow because it's my first time playing the deck. So, yeah. Probably be playing that deck again next time I play a league or next time I play a prelim. Because I like the Arcades deck and I do okay with it. I went, what did I go? I went 2-6 one day and then 6-2 the next. And last prelim I played, I think I went 2-2. So, dabs. Mr. Gaines. Kind of nice that you're a proactive deck. Don't have to worry too much about what your opponent's up to. All right. It's a little slow. They're playing something really aggressive. Also kind of bad if they have Fairy in their deck, but I think this is a keep. Cookbook, Daredevil, I can draw Garia's Vengeance, I can draw Ferdland, F-Tutor, I can draw Asmo. Like a lot of my draws are alive. Obviously, second Daredevil's probably not very good, but... I even type. Get to lose in style. I mean, turn on Ragavan. Thought they might do something like be playing something weird. And they said that. Maybe they are playing something weird. That's a good draw. Kid are just playing a thingy. Assuming just Shredder. I wonder if they're going to cast it. Probably. Okay, so they have two mystery, they have one mystery card right now. If I don't play the cookbooks now and I draw a land, my tokens are gonna be weak. Cause if I just play the two cookbooks and I draw a land, I probably just win. Play the two cookbooks and I don't draw land. Tutor. I don't think Tutor is going to save me this game. I'm just going to play the cookbooks and hope my top card is a land. Tutor worse than basic land confirmed. Just either clunky or someone has to ferry. This Merc that just races me. I erase this Profane Tutor too. Pretty terrible spots. Every card in their deck wrecks me, and I need to draw lands. We ever figure out if that works, or if I have to do it every time. I guess just a yes ability. Come on, land, please. No. What's the furthest thing you could draw from a land? We got the swamp I needed. It was Ragavan. Yeah. Well, I got food tokens I can sack. Okay. Kind of weird when I have food tokens to use your bolts, I feel, but... especially when you have extra mana from treasures and whatnot. Also, you could draw Shredder, you could draw... Dragon Rage Channeler, maybe. It's getting kind of scary territory. They can. I guess a lot of my cards do nothing for them. They're kind of close. Next turn. Next turn, they would have had it. So funny if they hard cast the tracks out for Agavan. Screenshot time. Uh-oh, put 12 on the card on the top. No good. An app to, I guess, that Profane Tutor. I was gonna say I have to draw two good cards in a row. That's a good draw. Now let's see. Problem is if they draw a counter, it's really bad for me. I don't get to gain the life, but I don't think it's especially close. Definitely gotta cast it. And hope. I mean, if they have a counter spell, I'm in a bad shape. I have tutor next turn though. Yeah. What did I tutor for? I guess I just tutor for Gora's Vengeance, right? And hope to draw an untapped land. We'll see. We'll see if anything makes sense. Anything else makes sense. No. I guess that's not my draw anyways. One less land though. I could get Urza Saga. Good tutor. Well, that makes it easy. Yeah. Wait, what? None of my cards do anything. Does Emrakul, they can just sack permanence block? Am I right? Tracks that it literally just block. What the hell? I guess it's just Asmo, right? Which means I don't have to draw land. Which is nice. If I get Gora's Vengeance, Emrakul doesn't kill them. Then I die on the backswing. Traxa just block. It's kind of funny. All right, it's just Asmo. Actually drew the land. All right, you have another counter spell. Unlikely. I have to kill them now. I guess I can make the food tokens now at least. Is there a reason? I think there's a reason to kill them now. I'd need to dodge bolt. Dodging Unholy Heat would be nice as well. Adawara. I guess. Not sure you have to do it now, do you? It's good if they draw Ragavan. Maybe they're just trying to give themselves max out. Wow. I like this. Sick play if they end up winning because they did it right away and played to their outs. Rather than wait. Ragavan kills me, Bolt kills me. Another iteration. Wait, what? Do I have iteration too? Jeez. Okay, not just Bolt kills me. I guess land plus Ragavan kills me. They kept on top? No, they put Chandler in the yard. I'm not sure why I'm not, like, yielding. Bubble. It's a lot of digging. A lot of digging. Oh, the Ragavan was one card away, one or two cards away. Wow. Hopefully they saw Gar's Vengeance. If Gar's Vengeance is tricky, it loses to Spell Pierce. And Spell Snare. That's a great draw. I get to get out of Bolt range. Yeah, let's do it now. Right. Old four cookbooks, I didn't even realize. Let him cook. All right, obviously going to gain the life right away. All right, somewhat stabilized. They need like removal plus Murktides. I guess removal plus Ragavan is good too. I don't know why they scooped there. I wasn't doing too much. Like they could just still win with iteration. All right, push seems good. Probably gonna bring in Blood Moon too. Spell Bomb is fine. Might is fine because the trades was Ragavan. What is not good against them? Also, what's their graveyard hate these days? Like, Hearse? Do I want Needle? Probably don't want both mites. How do I deal with hers? Don't do great against hers. Trim a tutor, it's all slow. I guess I just trim in this matchup. Blood Fountain has not been super impressive. Blood Fountain is probably bad in slow and grindy matchups. Oh, I don't know, yeah. Maybe I don't do second Basejo. This is probably just a bad matchup, honestly. Say that every round. No, that's not true. I didn't say that against Mail. Trying to think which one's worse. I think Emrakul is probably better. Maybe not. Because the tracks, I can just discard turn one to cookbook. I need to start building artifacts. I don't know. I mean. I guess I keep all in on the Giganta. I don't even have a one drop. Thanks. I was debating whether or not I should jam into potential spell pierce. Not sure what the answer is, to be honest. Counterspell, counterspell. Could take a counterspell. Yeah, I'll just do that. I can push. Maybe I can brutality first. Does that make sense? Probably not. Probably just makes sense to play push. Because Brutality will trade with counterspell anyways. And it makes them spend the mana, I guess. They even want to. Are you know about I am recall? I mean, that's another reason why Atraxa is better. You can actually just go turn two Brutality, discarding Atraxa, turn three Gora's Vengeance. Come here, you. Sure, that's what's gonna win me the game. Giganta Hardcasting Atraxa. Kind of running out of time. Running out of time if I'm gonna do the thing. Not a land, great. I guess I'll just jam into a. What did they do? Just jam into Counterspell. Hope they run out of gas and I top deck something good. They got rid of the Unholy Heat earlier. Maybe they don't have a removal for Giganta. We are definitely live. Definitely very live to win with hard cast attracts, huh? Okay, you'll have to see it. Canal in the yards. My draws have not been very good. What was my opening hand? Thoughtseize push? Push brutality? Thanks. I don't even think I can hardcast Emrakul in this deck. Okay. Resolves. One step closer to our dream. And if they kill it, I could sell Garya's Vengeance into Atraxa. I'll have to start drawing really well, though. Oh! Sad. Game's looking pretty over. Need multiple cards. There's a saga. I think we found a bad matchup. I think we found a reason why Stick's not gonna take over Modern. I guess my draw's been really bad. Maybe you have enough annoying stuff. Oh my god, really? Jeez. I mean, I know my opening hand was not great, but mulliganing against someone who has mostly answers to your stuff. Also, Ragaman turn on's really good against me. Uh-oh. They kept. What can I even draw? I don't think there's a single card I can draw at this point. At least they get to see how unlucky I am. I mean, yes. I'm dead on board to the hearse. Okay, this is probably better on the play. I don't think. Might doesn't even really work against hearse, right? They can turn it on and then kill it. Let's see. What's the most coherent for me? What's the most coherent approach? Don't need Might as badly. Because I'm on the play. Guess I probably want second Buseju. Root of Breach against the Spell Pierce deck just doesn't sound that great to me. Maybe one, because of the tutors. Then maybe cut another Emrakul. Maybe Blood Fountain is good in the late game to get back Asmo. Cicerus, what's your sideboard plan in this matchup? What could it be? First Blood Fountain seems kind of nice. Maybe Spell Bomb's too gimmicky. Turns up on Holy Heats. Might slow down American Chandler. Needle kind of feels bad too. All right, I mean, this is it, honestly. This is probably just what I want to see most games. Hoping not to see Ragavan and Blood Moon. Bubble, consider. Just a consider. Oh no, they drew something. They drew Ragavan. They drew consider. No? Usually you would play fetch land and target yourself with the bubble. That's why I was saying they drew Ragavan when they played Spire Bluff Canal. Maybe they're new with the deck, maybe they have a reason. Maybe they drew Spell Pierce. That would kind of make sense. All right, I'm gonna start making tokens. Get my value. I mean, if they have Blood Moon next turn, that one token could be relevant. Because now they kind of need Blood Moon to win this game. Now, at least if they play Blood Moon next turn, I get to go Asmo, I get to go Cookbook, Asmo, Cookbook, which is something. Make a pretty big token, I guess. Can maybe go all in on the token. Doesn't look like they have Blood Moon, though. Me taking Bubble was better than Consider. Because with Fetchland, it's kind of like a consider, but a free consider. Maybe that was a mistake, actually, I made. I'm not in a rush to play Asmo, not really. Let's just play a second cookbook. Let's get Giganta here, so I don't forget about it. I guess not have subtlety man up. That's fine. I can just keep making tokens. Let's start making food. Satch, too many lands. Yeah. I drew a lot of lands. Drew a lot of lands in game two as well. Did I just play a cookbook here? Seems kind of fine. Could have dress down. Dress down's annoying. Kind of getting gunned by dress down no matter what. Just make the token right away, I think. I mean, if they dress down now, it means they don't get the last token. If they have dress down, they're probably just happy to wait and take the five. Please, no dress down. See if they play subtlety. They feel like they need to rush. If they have dress down, Asmo might not save me. At least I get to get that needle. That almighty needle. Oh, I have Buseju. They let me untap. GG's, okay, they're not even gonna make me sweat. I think I just don't make a token, honestly. I mean, I'd be pretty sick if they were all friendly and gave me the GGs and then just had dress down in hand. There's almost no way, but I wonder what the correct play is. Because it's kind of hard for them to be two tokens. Did they use more clock than me? All right. Trophy dab. No, where did it go? Well, oh, there you are. All right, well, clearly the deck was perfect. No. That's a... Wait, is it Asmogorio? No, that's a different... Wait, what? When did I... Oh, I think I downloaded it the other day. I was like, oh, that deck looks sweet. I should save that just in case. Did I rename it? Am I losing my mind? Or is it just Cicerus? Yeah, pretty sure that's what happened. I like downloaded that list, changed the name to get ready just in case I want to play it. But let's see. The Leyline didn't really come up. I wasn't the matchups for now. Root of Breach won me a game. Push was okay. Murktide feels like kind of a tough matchup. I'm not sure there's much you can sideboard though to be better against Murktide. So like Jaunt, I mean, they have cheap removal, cheap counters, fast clock. Just more discard would be good, I guess. Like the rest might be good just to get, try to get rid of Dressdowns and Blood Moon and win with Urza's Saga. Not too sure though. But yeah, that's impressive. That's cool. And as always, if you made it this far, appreciate you watching. I hope you all have a great week, and I'll see you next time. Take care, everyone.